Hello, this is going to be a little video showing you a new phone that I've bought. I'm filming on my old phone, obviously, because I can't film with the same phone that I want to show you guys. I need a phone with features, and while I don't do an extremely a lot on my phone, I need it to be decent. So this is the Samsung Galaxy A24. My old one that I'm filming on right now is the A41. How you get a newer phone with a lower number on the model number, I don't know. But I got this on eBay, basically 180 quid. Bit more than I wanted to spend, but I got the features and spec that I wanted. So if we have a look here, I've put a case on this, by the way. You don't get this case with it. But if you're interested, I will put a link, if I remember, in the description for where I got this case. Came with a screen protector as well. So here we go. Let's have a little look. Samsung Galaxy A24. It has a 50 megapixel camera, main camera, 6.5 inch display. It comes with either 4 to 6 or 8 gigs. I've got the 4 gig version. It's got a 5,000 milliamp hour battery, which if we skip up here, you will see that its endurance rating, according to GSM Arena, which I really trust their reviews, is 141 hours. That is ridiculous in a good way. So, it's not too heavy. It's 195 grams. It's got more weight than my A41, but it's decent. It's not too thick, even with the case. Takes the usual nano SIM. It's dual SIM, so I've got two SIM cards in here, but I disable one of them because one of them I keep as pay-as-you-go for a backup, and the other one is the contract. So it's got a Super AMOLED 90 hertz display, which means that the blacks, they're not normal blacks. They're actually like just switched off pixels. So the blacks are extremely black. And anything that's black on this screen, in theory, based on everything I've heard before about Super AMOLED, doesn't use power. So that's really good. We've got quite a high pixel per inch rating. It comes with Android 13. Installed, but there will be several updates that you'll get. And since this only came out last month, May 2023, this is going to probably get 4 or 5 years worth of security updates, which is one of the big reasons why I got this. Okay, so it's got an octa-core processor, and when I was looking at reviews, this model looked like it was a lot better than an entry model, which I was looking at. But obviously not as good as a flagship, but I don't want flagship, and I certainly don't want to be spending flagship prices. So this phone is really capable for a not too crazy price. You can put, well, it's got 128 gigs of storage space built into it, but you can put a card into it, and I can't remember off the top of my head, but I think it's either 128 is the limit. I think something like that. Okay, so the cameras, we've got the normal wide lens, which has image stabilization, which is really cool, which means it kind of smooths out the picture. So instead of it being choppy, it's like nice and smooth. We've got an ultra wide, which is 5 pixels, which it's okay, but it's not the best. And really, I'm not particularly interested in the ultra wide. You've got a macro on here. So if you want to take really close pictures to stuff that to get really good details very close up, that's really good. I've tested that, and that's quite nice. For the video, it is only 1080p at 30 frames per second. I personally don't care. I don't need 4K. I just want to be able to make YouTube videos. So as long as it's HD and you can see, that's my priority. I don't want to go spending crazy money. Another important thing for me is it has a 3.5mm headphone jack, because I use standard headphones. I don't like having radio frequencies next to my brain if I don't need them. It's got the usual full shebang Wi-Fi capability. Bluetooth 5.3, because you really want your Bluetooth to be the latest one that you can get your hands on, for security reasons. Mine does have the NFC. You have to check that, because when I've been looking on Amazon for phones, the model should have NFC. But in the comments, everyone's like, hasn't got NFC. Why hasn't it got NFC? Well, it's because of the region where it was sold. I think this particular phone might be, I don't know, but when I look into the information on the phone, it might be from United Arab Emirates or whatever. So, but it's the normal installation process. You pick English and everything works on here. Perfect. It's USB-C 2.0. Now, the fingerprint is on the side. If I can get it to focus. All right. So, the fingerprint is on the side. So when I'm using it, all I do is just press my finger against it. I don't unlock my phone with fingerprint. I only use it once I'm on the phone, once I've typed in my password for my phone, then just for convenience, like banking and PayPal and Bitwarden and things like that, I'll just use that for, you know, just convenience factor. But the phone itself, if someone wants to steal it, it needs a full password. Someone can't just like chop my finger off or something. So you've got that accelerometer, gyroscope, compass, kind of usual stuff. Virtual proximity sensing. So I assume that means that when it's in your pocket, when you put a setting on, it won't accidentally turn on when it knows that you're not actually trying to press it. Comes in a variety of different colors, black, green, blue, red. It says here the price is approximately $200. I paid about $179, I think, delivered. And I bought it like at 3 something in the afternoon, and it showed up the next morning, which was very nice. And the speakers, okay. It's not amazing, but it's also not rubbish either. This is a mid-range phone. This isn't an entry-level garbage phone. It's not a flagship. So that's actually decent for what you're getting. And the battery life is just astounding. Like, to me, battery life is important. I remember the days when I used to charge my phone up once a week before I had smartphones. So any phone that's going to give me a lot of life is kind of important to me. So there you go. It's a decent size to it. It's definitely bigger than my old phone. I can't really show you a proper comparison, but it's probably like that much taller than my other phone that I'm filming on. But it's nice and snappy. Everything works on it. It's just really nice. So for me, I'm kind of picky. Like, I need certain features like fingerprint and good battery life, and it's got to be fast enough. And so if you're not sure, and you like Samsung phones, I personally would recommend this. It's kind of hard to find. I don't know if it's actually been released in the UK. There are some eBay sellers, but I went with the cheapest of the eBay sellers. There are some that are selling it for like $200, $230, $250. I went with the one that was $179 and crossed my fingers, and it worked out amazing. So that's why I thought I'd share that with you. So it's a brand spanking new phone, only just come out a month ago. So there you go. Now you can consider yourself informed of its existence. I highly recommend GSM Arena for getting specs on phones. and people's opinions and reviews. There isn't a review yet on this, but I have seen on their YouTube channel that they've been putting up sample photography. So if you search for Galaxy A24 and sort the filter on YouTube to date published, you'll find all the very latest stuff with Galaxy A24, and they do have some footage of the camera. So that makes me think that the review is not going to take too long to appear on here. So there you go. If you found this interesting or useful, please hit the like button, subscribe, and I will see you on whatever the next video happens to be about. Thank you.